what we've been doing is just looking at different approaches to solve for the x-intercepts. We've looked at completing the square, we've done factoring, we've done other things like that. Well, I use the Promethean board on a daily basis. I do things by color a lot. Like if we're switching a step, I'm using a different color. So students can generally see that distinct, like, all right, now this is what we're doing, now this is what we're doing. On one hand, it saves me a lot of time. But on another hand, I think it makes things a lot clearer for students. I'm just gonna switch our toolbar over here. But the most important reason why I do it is that I can turn every single lesson into a PDF that I put on a website. So our class has an Algebra 2 website. So if students are gonna be gone, you know, they know about it or not. At the end of the day, I have all of their notes posted. Every single day, a parent can go on the website and know exactly what we did in class that day. Or a student can see it. They can be like, yeah, that's right. You know, I did that problem. Okay, so we'll have our 4 because we don't want to forget this guy. It saves me time. Like, all my lessons are, I pretty much have the foundations for them every time I create one. Like, I can turn things off and on, so that way I don't have to repost them every year. I just have to turn them off. And to me, like, the biggest thing you can do to impact student success is, like, building relationships. It's like, building relationships, building relationships, building relationships. And, like, how do you do that when you have so many students? And just remember, when you're doing your work, right? A lot of times, like, I'm throwing kids pictures on there all the time. I think just little techniques like that, like, you know, now the student knows, like, I recognize them as, like, a member of our class. I don't know, like, it makes that connection just so much stronger. Okay, so after this, what should we do?
Add 0.5625 to what will be the perfect square and then subtract it out.
I think it's made a huge impact on my ability to teach because a lot of the ways I use my lesson setups is there's prompts. Like, there's certain things, like, I do not want to forget. Instead of, like, having you guys tip me, like, I would give you tips. And remember, we're trying to find the roots. So on one hand, it, like, keeps me in check and makes sure I'm hitting every checkpoint that I want. It also just opens up your time. I already have these slides pre-made, so I'm not spending time, like, writing stuff on the board. So, like, when I'm trying to do the clerical part of the position, like taking attendance or checking in homework, the time it normally would take me to write some of this stuff down, I'm getting that managerial side taken care of, so it's giving me more class time or more time to engage my students in curriculum instead of clerical stuff. We're trying to find the roots. What does that mean?
We're trying to solve for x when y equals 0.
And you guys are good. You must have a good math teacher. One thing that I do is at the very beginning of the year, I create like this database that has like all the parents' emails. It takes a lot of work on the front end. But then after that, it's really easy for me to send an email to all of my parents or guardians. I can bring mathematics home in a way that a lot of times it's not. So for example, if I send a letter home to parents at the end, I always give the parents a question to ask their student. A lot of times a parent doesn't know whether or not the question is right or not, but at least they're able to ask that question. They're able to engage and kind of connect with their student on that respect, which they might not have before because they wouldn't have even known what question to ask. What do you think? Do you think you entered this right? So the students know, like, not only am I holding them accountable, but at home they're being held accountable too. Let's move on with the lesson. All right, so our learning goals are just the same as yesterday. Last year when I taught here, I had 5 different classrooms. I had 5 different setups. We're gonna combine some like terms. It's been kind of nice this year because I have my own room. It's all set up. I don't have to worry about it. If I get it going in the morning, I know I'm set for the rest of the day. So I think there's tons of rewards after you kind of invest the time and effort into it.
Can you just put -24 in the parentheses right there?
The response has been just overwhelmingly positive. We're gonna add this in just like Josh said. When you kind of use it in new innovative ways, you're gonna catch students off guard. It allows them to actually like get engaged with the material, which before, like, if they're not even looking at it, they're not even giving them themselves a chance to engage in it. So you guys just solved that quadratic equation using the quadratic formula. Are you pretty proud of yourselves? All teachers, like, I think they want to do it. Like, everybody wants to do it, or they've been thinking about it, it's been on their mind. Just like, quit thinking about it and just do it. Like, because once you're used to it, like, it just rolls out so much faster. But like, you have to like jump into it. If you don't jump into it, like, you're just gonna keep thinking about it. Like, just do it.